Pugsy, welcome. How's it going? Half, welcome. How's it going? E, welcome. How's it going, everyone? Let's do it. Addy, how's it going? Welcome. Okay. Happy Splatfest to you too, Pugsy. I did a few matches yesterday before streaming Sonic Frontiers, but now I'm gonna be playing with you guys for the next 2 hours. But first, there is something I got to do. Let's check out all the new stuff. Completely useless. Safety of your blanket. Yeah. Nice and warm. Okay, I'm gonna really quickly check Splatnet 3 for any new stuff real quick. I don't think there's any new stuff. I think I have every piece of gear in the game that's available so far, so guess we'll find out real quick. Okay, let's see. Oh, it won't help to check the shirts anyway, so. Okay, I'm pretty sure I've got those shoes. You have to right there. I know I've got that shirt. I know I've got that shirt. I know I've got that. Okay. I've got literally everything in Splatnet 3 currently. So, let's check the shops. I did not need to go to weapons. Giving you tickets. Seriously. At least now we can use conch shells on it. Oh, look. Yeah, apparently you can actually buy this shirt at the shop as well. How much is it worth? 8,000. Oh, pretty good. Nothing new, nothing new, and nothing new. Okay. Yeah. If the Octo T doesn't show up, that's gonna be my new shirt. All right, let's go. The shade of blue for water is actually pretty nice. Team Water 2? Nice! For anyone who is on Team Water, you can join as you wish. Typical password. So yeah, what do you guys are excited for the next catalog we'll be getting here by the end of the month? You're on Team Fire? That's cool. I like the little thing they added where it shows you which team you're on as the battle starts. But the thing is, we don't necessarily, it's not really necessary because we know which team we're on. And if we get a mirror match, we don't need to know whose team it is because the colors are different from the Splatfest colors, and it's like we know we're fighting our own team. We can tell which team is which just by the colors. We don't, It's not a it's not a necessary thing, but it's I guess it's a nice to have. It makes the game look a little more flashy. It's pretty cool. Oh, they give us more cool stuff. Yeah, seriously. Okay, waiting for anyone else to show up who was going to join. Boink. Actually, let me cancel that really quickly. When she joined right now? It's cool. I'm gonna try getting used to a higher sensitivity. That's safe, right? Just want to make sure, yeah. Okay, good. This way, if I need to, I can quickly make a turn around real quick to hit people, but it's gonna require a lot of, you know, managing how fast I do it. Okay, there's room for one more person. For anyone who wants to join, now is your chance. Anyone go and join? Squish! A triple! You're coming? Alrighty. And the Splatfest Surfer mode once the Splatfests are over? They should! They have no reason to, I mean, it'd be a really good idea to. Should try practicing squid rolling into attacking. That wasn't directly what? Alright, let's go. Let's do it. Good luck, everybody. So yes, every two games, I will reset the lobby so more people can join. If there's a spot open and no one has joined, you may rejoin. Did a Sonic Splatfest? That'd be really cool. I'd like to see that. But knowing Nintendo, they're probably not going to because they're like, yeah, no. I mean, it'd be perfect though. You can have a Sonic vs. Tails vs. Knuckles Splatfest. That's a no-brainer, but Nintendo lacks the cools. Oops, ow. Nintendo lacks the cools, so we all know they're not going to do something cool like that. Drinks! Whoops! Hello! Hello, Charger! I didn't get you. What? I'm definitely gonna need to get used to this higher sensitivity. I overshot it way too much. But the reason I want to be used to a higher sensitivity is in those cases where someone's behind me and I can just immediately turn around if I have to. But yeah. Time to go over another learning curve. Getting used to the higher sensitivity. Ouch. You failed to shoot down my torpedo, though. Give me those drinks. Okay, we got the team pinned down. Actually, if you're defending in a tri-color match, you can only no. If you're attacking, you can have up to one, friend, but if you're defending, doesn't mean you can have up to four people as well? Or is it just, again, just pair up with one friend and play with two randoms? I hope that's not the case, because there's four players, you should be able to play with four people. Ouch. Don't let them make that comeback. Yeah. GG's. As much as I like the breakdance, I kind of prefer the default animations, even though the winning animation for the Splatoon is admittedly kind of lame. Dylan, how's it going? Can you join? If you're on Team Water, then yes, you can. If not, then you actually will not be able to, unfortunately. But as long as you're on Team Water, you can join. However, I'm going to do one more quick match, and then I'll reset the lobby. Bonk. This has some really serious DPS. This is taking a minute, isn't it? There we go. Good luck, team. The one thing I like about this stage, Scorched Gorge, is that it looks like it takes place somewhere near the crater. It's kind of cool looking. Which is neat. Unfortunately, the way this map plays is absolute garbage. It is such a spawn camp friendly map and it sucks. But visually, it's pretty cool looking. Oh, excuse me. That didn't one hit you. Goo! Eat it. I got more range than you. It's really odd because it's like the game is making it so that even with the melee weapon, it's making you want to have to play with range. Which is just really funny, if you ask me. Nice try, buddy. Gotta move. Drinks. That's always something. Like, if a map looks really cool, it plays like trash, but if it doesn't look that all that interesting, it plays really well. It's like Nintendo just can't do both at the same time. Which sucks, honestly. I would like a map that looks both looks really cool and plays really well. Unfortunately, doesn't seem like we can get both. Because of Nintendo, it's either one or the other. You cannot have both. Gotcha. Let's go. No, I'm out of pink. Okay. How did my torpedo not get ya? Gosh darn it. Lols. Ugh. That looks like a lose, but hey, I'll take it. We did it, team. Nice going. Funnily enough, this matches my the schedule for the Splatfest actually match my currently with the, you know, a fallback thing going on. It makes the Splatfest match my schedule, stream schedule, really nicely, because I stream 2 to 4, which is when the maps and modes update now, instead of 5. Which means that by the time this stream ends, Tri-Killer is going to be a thing, and that's pretty much going to be the focus of next stream, because by the time the Splatfest ends is when my stream ends, so that's quite literally perfect timing. Okay. For those of you who are in that current lobby, please sit out and let others get the chance to join. Glugamane, how's it going? Gonna lurk and try drawing my characters? Nice. Oh, you're Team Water too? Nice. If you do want to join, you're more than welcome to, because if you're on Team Water, you can play. And I'm gonna dare use this weapon. Ugh. Jeez. I have several clips of me hitting, like, targets, like, 5 or 6 times with this thing. And they still did not get splatted. Here's the funny thing about these test dummies in the range, though, or whatever. Like, they're not a reliable source of damage. Like, if you're trying to get the damage of a weapon, this isn't a reliable source, because these guys, unlike human players, can't regain health by submerging in ink. So these guys have a constant damage. While playing against an actual human player, they can recover health slowly over time within their ink. So. Yeah. So yeah, these test dummies are not an accurate source for damage with these weapons. Especially this one. All three don't even one hit. That's insane. And this is probably the worst kit possible this weapon could have had. Okay, for those who want to rejoin, you may do so now. Toxic Mist is probably by far the worst sub-weapon in the game due to the indirect changes that that Nintendo made for this game compared to Splatoon 2. Especially with the new movement options. Toxic Mist does quite literally nothing. It quite literally does 0% anything. If it had a DOT effect, then yeah, it'd probably be good. But no. It is not at all good at, like, seriously. Leaked on Scarlet and Violet? The starters of all forms are amazing. Nice. I don't think I'll be playing Scarlet and Violet. A Pokemon just isn't really my thing. I played a Sword, and I haven't, and I kind of stopped after the first battle of the post story. Or of, whatever. Jeez. Speed, how's it going? Welcome. If you wish to join, you are more than welcome to. Oh wait, you're crud, I forgot you're on Team Fire. You won't be able to. Dang it. The one thing that sucks about Splatfests. Subspace, how's it going? Welcome. We got the original trio here. Nice. The shade of blue for water is actually really nice. I like it. Is this the team we fought earlier? Wouldn't be surprised. I run into the same people over and over again in random turf wars. Online, public, random turf wars, I run into the same people over and over again. Is that literally just how little people are playing this game right now? Wouldn't be surprised. I locked the range. JK, it's cool. I suck. Even though we're on a different team, this is just for fun. I can't stand how this is not a one-hit weapon. It's a potential one-hit weapon. You need all three shots to connect for it to one hit, and that is a rarity with online latency. And if your target is off just by even a slight itsy bitsy teeny tiny little bit, it's not gonna hit. So with online latency, yeah, good luck. And Toxic Mist at least slows them down a little bit, but this weapon would have fared much better with something like a burst bomb to pair. Oh. To pair with its, yeah, that still didn't one hit. That says it all right there. Anyway, a burst bomb would have been far better to pair with the explosive, the radius of the little trifolds. Don't see how that'd be OP because you need to take a second to charge it too. Now putting burst bombs on something like an Octobrush, yeah, that would be OP. Toss. Oh, that's a teammate. Duh. Okay. Yeah, and combined with the squid roll, jeez. You gain a quick little second of bank armor, so good luck landing in one hit with this thing anyway. Special admittedly could have been better. You can only lock onto three targets at a time versus tandem missiles, you can lock onto everybody. And in my opinion, tandem missiles are just a lot better. Sheesh. An idea for Splatoon is? Let's hear it. Do-do-do. Oh, like a guitar. Oh, that'd be kind of cool. So it'd be like playing the strings on a guitar, but there's little shockwaves that damage opponents. That'd be kind of interesting. But yeah, how's this Splatfest currently going for you, Subspace and Speed? Jeez, that took a minute. an idea. Noise. I'd like to see a Splatana weapon that looks more, that's treated, you know, looks more like a longsword than a katana. But that would kind of defeat the purpose of the name, Splatana. It's supposed to be a katana, which is still close enough to us, because it's still basically a sword. It's still an E-blade, which is really cool. So yeah. Which is why I'm maining it. I like swords. A lot. Now, if we got the dapple dualies, which are toothbrushes, but imagine being able to actually swing around a toothbrush like an actual... Uh-oh, we got a mirror match. See? I could tell it was a mirror match before we even saw the opposite team, because the shade, because our color is not blue. So, those little indicators are not necessary at all. We can clearly tell which team we're on, but they do look nice. It's a flashy kind of... It's like a... I guess this is the one time Squid Party and it's viable. Because no one wins or loses. So... What are you gonna do? No one wins or loses, so... I guess this is the one time Squid Party is viable in an actual Turf War. Or a Splatfest. The one instance, though. And as such, I actually wouldn't mind joining, but it doesn't look like my team in particular wants to Squid Party. It looks like everyone just wants to fight. Come on, we're on the same team, guys. I didn't want to aim at you. I wish you could manually select the targets with these things like you can tenon missiles. That'd help out a lot with it. Okay, I'll Squid Party a little bit. But not too much. I'm just gonna watch them slide each other. While I throw in a little bit of explosive ordnance, my darn self. I don't want to target the person who's Squid Partying because they just want to have a good time. Win or lose, it don't matter. I won't be doing a Squid Party because... yeah. I still want to get a little bit of ink for the cloud, though. Hello, person. Sorry, but I'm not gonna Squid Party with you. I'm still gonna do inking because I want some clout. I guess it won't hurt to splat those on my team. Oh boy. Like, literally, this weapon is like a combination of X-Flasher and Charger. The nuances it has make it hard to use, and as such, I don't think it's a very good idea for a weapon. Especially when you need all three shots to actually connect to make it a one hit. If it was just one bolt that worked like a Charger, even if it had a slight arc to it, that would still make it a 10,000 times better weapon. Because it'd be a consistent one-hit. This thing, right now, is nothing more than a potential one-hit. Which, to me, just makes it freaking suck. If there is one thing I dislike in any game, regardless of which one it is, it's inconsistency. I can't stand inconsistency. Maybe the kid could be... and splat bombs? Killer Whale, not so much. I think Ink Vac would be much better for the Tri-Stringer than Killer Whale. But Burst Bombs, I think, would be a perfect fit for it. You can pair the Burst Bomb damage with the quick little explosive bolts. That would be super good. It'd help with mobility, too, because this thing lacks mobility so badly because its trails, the ink trails that it leaves are very disconnected. You can't swim through them. You can barely do so. Okay, so that's two games. Reset in the lobby. Let's see what I get. Be something good. And... thank you. Yeah, what weapon should I use now? The guitar? I mean, it depends on how it pans out. See, this is the only time you can actually do any real moving with it, and... that takes a second. Normally, Yeah, good luck swimming through this. Very freaking disconnected. Splatoon stringer guitar. Okay, imagine a combination of the stringer and the Splatoon where you shoot Splatoons instead of whatever this thing is shooting. Typical password? Here we go. But yeah, I really think an ideal kit for the stringer would be burst bombs and ink vac. I think that'd be very solid. As for the Splatana, I would like to see Fizzy Bomb and Booyah Bomb, but that combo already exists with the vanilla blast slushing machine. But Nintendo reuses kits all the time, so there's no reason that kit can't happen. There's no reason they can't make that a thing. Oh, here's an interesting question. Which brand do you think would make the new brand weapons? In Splatoon 2, we got Kensa. I'm willing to bet in this game it's gonna be Aniki. Because Aniki has some pretty good gear in this game. So I'm guessing we're gonna get Aniki weapons in this game, along with Kensa weapons and Sheldon's picks. Nintendo has no reason not to do so. Especially if this is the last game in the franchise. Right, Nintendo? Right, Nintendo? Okay, let's go. Tenetech? That's an interesting one. Tenetech, I think, is best known for their Tenetech Splatter Shot because that seems to be a fan favorite. A good solid Jack of all trades weapon. Unfortunately, Nintendo ditched that and went with. Nintendo changed that up and made the vanilla Splatter Shot the Jack of all trades this time around. Do-do-do-do. I mean, Trash Blaster. Lol. Barazushi? That's another possibility. That is a brand new brand entirely, after all, so. Was Kensa a brand in Splatoon 1? I don't think it was. No, I think Tony Kensa made their appearance in Splatoon 2. Therefore, the new weapons might actually be the brand new brand. The Barazushi. A 10 times battle! And I had to be using this weapon, didn't I? If we lose, I blame myself. Time to experience tryhard mode on the other team. But the same goes for us too, so. I got both ways. I see you up there, you Hydra. Yep. Now watch as Toxic Mist does literally nothing to do it. Does literally nothing. Jeez, what is this, a raid party? Okay, that's the greatest threat right here. And get taken out. Yeah, we can make a push. We can try to, anyway. Dude, this Splatfest theme is really good. The name of it's a little depressing, but at the same time, kind of wholesome. It's like both. It's like depressing but wholesome. But the song itself just is a banger. Dang. I'm gonna save my killer whale for when the Hydra wants to get back up on top there. And I'm afraid to actually go forward. I'm afraid to push forward a little bit because this weapon is not a Slayer weapon, and by any means. It's a potential one hit. Doesn't mean it's an actually good one hit. Because that's not what it is. Dude, this thing's object damage is even trashy. The Splatana, oddly enough, has really freaking good object damage if you direct hit something with it. That thing gets rid of Wave Breakers in one hit if it's direct. The Splatana has got serious object damage to it. Okay, this is a fight I cannot win unless I have better positioning. How did that not one hit? I need an explanation, please, game. Team is named Mom. I know. We can all appreciate the lack of creativity of some names in this game. I'm gonna go ahead and just try to make a quick little push. Hopefully that worked. Calamity, how's it going? Welcome. Bleh. I blame myself for using the worst weapon in the game. For losing that one. Dun-dun. We had him on the a back foot for most of the match, though. Two splats. Wow, so good. Since we can get those ones. Okay, I'm gonna use this weapon one more time, and then probably not use it for the remainder of this stream, because this weapon is either hit or miss. Quite literally. Literally and figuratively. But I still do not get its intended role. I feel like this weapon is supposed to be chip damage, just to make it easier for your teammates to splat opponents. Which is probably the weakest possible weapon design you could have in a game like this, since people are already taking chip damage through being an enemy ink. So this weapon is, if that's the role, it's just redundancy and it serves no purpose. So hopefully the future kits of this weapon will actually make it viable. Because as it stands right now, this particular kit... what can you say about it? Other than it's called the I Want to Lose weapon. Scorched Gorge. Variety Society. So you don't know which team to do? So you just picked water because you love water. Makes sense. Funnily enough, I don't really play Pokemon either, but I did play Sword. And my starter Pokemon was Sobble, which is a water type, so that's why I'm going with water. That and it's blue, which is my favorite color, so. It's a win-win. And the particular shade of blue is actually pretty good. It looks really nice. Seriously, that didn't even take out the sprinkler? So this thing doesn't do damage to enemies or objects. And that was lucky. They swam into my shots. I feel like that's the only way you can actually get any splats with this is if someone actually runs into your shots. Some of the splats I've gone with this weapon have been legit ones because I knew where they were going. Just like that. And just like that. But for the most part, this weapon is really hard to use. In fact, it's so hard that it's like the learning curve for it doesn't even matter. Because that's how bad it is. Okay, I'm actually gonna do a little bit of- Oh boy, I'm gonna die. I swear, if I got splatted by that, I would have been upset. Oh. Jeez. Samashi, how's it going? Welcome. Way too much Sonic Frontiers. You can never play way too much Sonic Frontiers. Because that game is simply amazing. Sega really delivered on that game. They really did. They have far succeeded my expectations. Ugh. If you could store a charger with this weapon, that would also help it out a lot. Okay, why did I use this? There's no targets to lock onto. I'm a big doofus. Okay, that's definitely a win. After the second Titan, just finished the crane game. Noice. Be warned though, the little mini game thing they have for you to progress within the next area, or for the third Titan, is actually kind of dumb, if I'm being honest. It's cool. It's a nice little homage to, you know, the classic Sonic pinball machines, but they went a bit overboard with it. I'll just say that much. Not gonna spoil it any further. Okay, that was two matches. Reset in the lobby. Let's go. First, let me switch my weapon out. Let's go. Oh wait, did I get another conch shell? I don't think I did. No, I didn't. Just wanted to make sure. The magic conch shell! One, zero, zero, eight. You've been mostly avoiding spoilers. Yeah, that's the furthest I'll go. It's a nice little homage to classic pinball machines we see in the franchise, but they went a little, they kind of overdid it a bit. Yoink. Then again, I am playing the game on hard difficulty, so maybe that was also something that influenced how much I needed. I don't know. It could be. Yoink! A triple! The mini bosses are so fun except for the tank. Not a fan of the tank. Trying to remember what that one is. Tank. Can't remember what that one is, honestly. The shark in the second world is actually pretty fun. Okay, there's room for two more people who want to join. Feel free to jump right in. Collat! That's a lot of clout. Well, for Christmas, I'm not sure if we'll be getting a Christmas Splatfest, because that'd just be 1 month after this one. If we do get one, it's gonna be like near the start of January, and by that point, it's like the Christmas season's kind of over by then. But no, Nintendo skipped out on a Halloween one and a Christmas one, both, due to putting their own promotional one for Pokemon in November. They don't even have a Thanksgiving one. I mean, not everyone celebrates Thanksgiving, but, you know. Okay, room for one more. Anyone wants to join? Feel free to. A Sonic Splatfest? That would be so cool. Sonic versus Tails versus Knuckles is the best thing I can think of. Or maybe they can make it more referencing to Sonic Frontiers and make it be the first three islands. Which of the first three islands was your favorite? They could do that. That'd be a little interesting. But knowing Nintendo, they're probably not going to do anything Sonic related in this game. Because they have an inferiority complex. Roasted! Team Sonic versus Team Dark versus Team Rose. But then where's Team Chaotix? Yeah, they did miss out on a good opportunity for a Sonic Splatfest for Frontiers. But then again, yeah, I don't see any Sonic-related Splatfest happening at all. Even though this game would be the right time to do it, because there's three teams you can choose from. So something as simple as Sonic versus Tails versus Knuckles would be perfect. Something as simple as that would work just fine. I can only imagine the shade of blue for Team Sonic. I think that would look so freaking cool. The shade of blue would be like a supersonic neon blue color. That'd be so dope. Sucks to be Team Chaotix. Bloom! Sonic Splatfest and Knuckles. That like a and Knuckles reference? Oh, what? I wasn't close enough. I wasn't close enough! How did my torpedo not finish you off? Did they shoot it down? I didn't see it. I see you. Your ninja squid doesn't help you because I can see your trails. Seriously, a ninja squid indirectly got buffed in this game. Okay, the funny thing about this game is that if anything gets buffed, it's indirectly. Making it so that any of the nerfs are almost non-existent. Which is funny to me. Defeats the purpose of why they nerfed it in the first place. Oop, that's a crab pink. There's actually a boss in Sonic Frontiers that looks very similar to the crab tank, if you can believe it. See, I can see your trail. I saw you coming. Your ninja squid did not help you, buddy. Nobody's there. See, that's why it pays to have a higher sensitivity, right there. I probably wouldn't have gotten that splat if I wasn't able to move as quickly like that. Na 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 na. Oh boy, that's a Trizuka. Almost ready to charge in. Let's go. Hello? Your ninja squid didn't help you. I saw your trail. I threw it in your direction. Doink. Hopefully, that was enough. You go back to World 1, you need to refight the boss. I'm hoping so. Ghost of M, how's it going? Welcome. Close game, GG's. For the Splatoon guitar idea. So I imagine it would be like a lighter weight Splatoon, kind of. Like you can, you know, swing the horizontal swing a lot faster, but it does less damage. Oh my gosh. Doggo cameo. Oh my gosh. Once they start, they don't stop. So until they cool down, I'm gonna go ahead and mute. I'm gonna go on mute, but until they cool down. Okay, I think they're done. Maybe the game's noise. That's a lot. Oh yeah, play the new Sonic game, definitely. I am a true blue Sonic fan. True blue Sonic fan right here. Oh, you're looking a bit ancient. I wanted a squid roll there. Hello, whoa. Why did it go in that direction? Excuse me, I feel like I had no control over that one. No, 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 there we go. Let's go back up here. Ugh, I'm stuck. There we go. Doink! Keep them coming! Ask and you shall receive. Hello. See, this is the problem with this map. It is so easy to pin the enemy team down. Where's the fun in that? Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Thank you, Nintendo. What's the matter, Nintendo? You can't help me doing... You don't like it when I'm doing good with the Splatoon? You don't like that? I'll just clip that. I literally am clipping every time a communication error happens, and I wanna count them all up by the end of Splatoon 3. Just to show how unready this game is. And how much Nintendo rushed it. Seriously. The Owl House? I have not heard of that, actually. Thank you, Nintendo. Yoink! Yoink! Are you guys actually still in the match? Or was it just me Nintendo kicked out because they're like, oh no, you're not allowed to do that good, sorry. You are? Oh my gosh. Hopefully you're still winning. I was curious to see how many splats I would have gotten that match. But no, Nintendo's like, you lost? Wow. Thank you, Nintendo. You guys are abysmal. The worst gaming developing company on planet Earth. Pokéfest. Thank you, Ghost of M. Have a good one. Or have you never gotten a DC? You're pretty darn lucky in that case. Because it's not even my internet. Because my internet is just fine. It's actually really good. But Nintendo's like, oh, what's this? Oh, he's doing good. Hey, not anymore. They're winning too? Oh, time to rig the game. Blue, how's it going? Welcome. Yeah, I'm literally clipping every time a communication error happens. And I want to count how many clips I have of that alone. After 3 years of Splatoon 3. Before, but not. Exactly. It's like not even the people's internet's fault. Admittedly, some people do have really trashy Wi-Fi. But other than that, yeah. And Nintendo has the audacity to say, if this error persists, check your internet. And I'm like, no, Nintendo, it's not my internet, it's you guys. Stop being self-centered. Seriously. The only person you're fooling is yourselves. That's the kind of stuff I can't stand. When they're blaming you for something they did, it is so obnoxious. It's just a sign of self-righteousness. Nintendo is clearly the self-righteous type. Gotta go. How's it going, buddy? Oop, gotta move. Not sure what just happened there, but I'll take it. No, you don't. Ooh, I'll take that double. Jeez, let me tell you, once you get the hang of a weapon like this, it is so fun to use. Just get past the learning curve and you're there. How are you? How'd you not get splattered after that hit? That's what I want to know. Come on, I could have had that. I could have had that. Zoom! I wish they would throw the torpedo just a little bit further. I'll take it. Yeah! Bird on the slot. It's cool. I'm resetting the lobby after this one because the last one was dumb. Let's freaking go. 11 splats. Yeah. I still wonder how much I would have gotten if Nintendo didn't. Freaking DC me. Okay, so that was 2, right? Yeah, so it is time for a reset. We did one match. Second one was a DC because yay, Nintendo. Well, no, what happened was... I did one before that, but then... The second one was a DC, I think? Yeah, second one was a DC, and then Nintendo was like, no, you're not allowed to play what you paid for. Oh, wait, did I get a conch shell yet? I don't think I did. I'm not paying attention. No. Haven't been paying attention. No, I'll stick with this weapon. I'm doing pretty good with it. I made it after all. Okay, new room, same password, yada hoo ha. One more hour of streaming to go. Then we'll be introduced to Tricolor, which I will be streaming tomorrow. Yoink! If you think about it, the Ultra Stamp is pretty much just a longer range Splatana. Net! Okay, one more spot open for anyone who wants to join. It's gonna be rare like last time now. And I think that was just for the last Splatfest. Nintendo made it so that you only have a 2% chance of getting into a Tricolor Turf War. As a way to make it so that... And like, kind of as a band-aid fix for it. Until they thought of a way to actually fix it. Which is just stupid. Come on. I understand it's a new concept that they introduced, so obviously it's not going to be perfect. But that was far from well thought out. Seriously. Stormy, how's it going? Welcome. I don't know, if the current winning team loses overall due to Tricolor, then that just means that if you're winning in the first half, you're not going to win overall. That's literally all that means. And it's like Tricolor was made just to make it so that if you think you're winning, oh, not anymore. Angle shooter. Net. Ooh, I suck. Are you still up there? Yes, you are. Not anymore, you might. Uh-oh. How'd you live that? Greetings! Oh shoot, I was on. I overshot it. Yay! I probably could have taken him taking all three of them out if I didn't overshoot that one. Let's go. Who threw that? Wait a minute, what? That was interesting. I need to clip that to see what happened. What was that? Jeez. Ugh. I'm starting to remember why I use ink res. But I feel like ink res is nerfed to heck in this game. Oh, come on, I could have had a quad. But dude, I am freaking killing it with this weapon. That didn't seem like it was close, but yeah, 12 splats, yeah, new record. Almost got another conch shell. I'll probably have another conch shell after the next two matches. Let's go. Which one did it lock onto? Kept hitting clips. Yeah, jeez. Seven party shells and you haven't got 100 or 3. Make sure to spend those at the slot machine because after the Splatfest is over, those disappear. You don't get to, you know, save them up. So yeah, make sure that you spend those. And if you're worried that spending them will make it so that you don't get the points for them, no. As soon as you earn one, the point counts towards the Splatfest. Oh. So yeah, use them as you get them. You got nothing to lose for doing so. Instead, you have everything to gain! Oh. I suck. Wait, what? Where did the second slash go? It just disappeared. Weaverin was hype. Yo, Weaverin was a really cool boss fight. Okay. For those of you who are currently watching my Sonic Frontiers playthrough, I do plan on doing a second one. Because, on account of my own stupidity, I did not parry properly throughout my first one, making it so that you guys missed out on a lot of really cool supersonic cinematics. So I want to do a second playthrough for you guys so you guys can actually see them. I am overshooting it big time. Wow, I swam into the shockwave. I am so good at this game. No, I thought I fully charged it. I thought I had fully charged it. I guess I didn't. But yeah, I am going to be doing a second playthrough, just so you guys can actually see, like, a better playthrough than the current one. I almost did not even see that until it was too late. You don't parry Weaver, you gotta science dip. I know, the actual attacks, you can parry. Get out of here. Wait, where'd you go? Where'd you go? Like, the scratches the Weaver throws at you, you can actually parry those. Doink! I need to stop overshooting. That's my biggest problem right now. Toxic miss. Having a sub-weapon that doesn't ink anything in this game is actually kind of detrimental. If you think about it. Does an amazing job at the boss hype. Like, seriously. The music is freaking spot on. Being good at the charger. Well, no, here's the thing about Splatoon. Like, even if you're really good with a weapon, that doesn't mean you're going to perform well every match. Because there are counters to weapons. You just need to find the right strategy. Like, for that one, I kind of just rushed in and didn't. Oh, wait, no. Oh, nope, don't happen. I kind of just rushed in like an imbecile. And that's what cost me a lot of good splats. Because they had a lot of range at their disposal. But yeah, I will be doing a second playthrough of Sonic Frontiers, just so you guys can see what you missed due to my own incompetence. Though, I'll admit, having beaten the bosses the way I did is actually kind of impressive. Thank from Rena Kelly Eric for the Splatfest. That no, you're cool. Wait, okay, it's cool. I think okay, the reason I'm not using Ninja Squid on this weapon is because despite the indirect buff, it's kind of nerfed to heck in this game because there are so many subs and specials that can just point out your location. You've got torpedoes, auto bombs, toxic mist, point sensors, angle shooters, tenna missiles, killer whale 5.1. Like, there is a lot of things to counter in this game. And getting into a match where no one is using either of those, regardless of a mode you're playing, is a rarity, so Ninja Squid is not the best ability in this game. It's got more counters than normal. Plus, I can still see the trail of ink people use it leave behind as they're swimming, so it's kind of outright useless in this game. Not to mention it slows down your swim speed, so it just makes you eat your target. Any weapon? Try the basic splatter shot. Na-na-na-na-na-na. Doink. Jeez, that's well, wow, okay. Blasters, oddly enough, in this game are actually really strong. I went to a match and used the normal blaster and range blaster, and I did really well with them. I don't know what they did to change it. Here's the funny thing about this game. I don't know what they did to change whatever weapons, but in Splatoon 2, I could not use blasters for anything. In this game, I can do relatively well with them. Same with the X-Washer. In Splatoon 2, I couldn't use the X-Washer for anything. In this game, I have a relatively easy time using it. I don't know what they did. I don't know what they did to change things up, but sheesh. Either that or I just got better at the game. I don't know. Maybe a little bit of both? When has a meme team of Booyah Bombs? I guess we could try that. We'll do that next lobby. This lobby, let's all go. Whatever weapon we choose. And then next time we can all go Booyah. Oh no, I'm out of ink. That's like how I typically get splatted in this game, because I always run out of ink at the worst possible time. That's why I'm going to make sure in my main setup I use Ink Saver main and sub. Hello, could I have tank? Oh my gosh, I'm out of ink. I don't know, I just feel like ink is more important in this game than it's been in the previous two installments. Can't tell you why. Na-na-na-na. Whoa. This is bad. Bad positioning. Another crab tank. Yay! Get a little closer. Oh, come on. Oh, I was behind you. Okay, this guy's lagging a little bit. Are these YouTubers in our match? I don't think so. I don't think they are. If so, then that just kind of says what I said earlier. I guess that's just how little people are playing this game. You just run into the same people every match, even if it's completely random. No, I didn't want to do the lunge. I did not want to do the lunge. I did not want to do the lunge. That screwed me. Da-da. Ouch. Yes, do something. What? Ouch. Boink. Yeah. Yeah, that guy is definitely lagging. I was behind him and they splatted me. That makes sense. Da-na-na-na-na. Da-na-na. Da-da-da. Maybe I'll join tomorrow's stream? Nice. Because if I'm kind of hoping that we end up defending the tower or whatever, because I've only ever been on a team that has to try and capture the Ultra Signal, so I want to see what it's like to be on the defending team. Yeah, that map is absolutely abysmal. It is such a spawn camp friendly map. And I find it fitting that Nintendo showcased that map before any other ones, because it's like they gotta represent themselves, you know? Trash. So, what better way to represent themselves than to showcase the worst weapon in the game first before any other weapon, and showcase one of the worst maps in the game before any other one? Try Stringer and Scorch Gorge. Gotta represent yourselves, don't you, Nintendo? Trash. Okay. This lobby, we can. Wait, was that just one game? I think I'm losing track. Actually, no, I don't think that was two. Okay, so I'm gonna do three games this lobby. Whoopsies! That's okay though, because I can do three games this lobby. And then after this match, we can do the whole Booyah Bomb thing that someone mentioned. Doink! How long does it take to actually get to 99.9? This weapon is actually surprisingly really good in Salmon Run as well. Yoink! I guess I'll do three matches this lobby and then we can do main team Booyah Bomb. That actually one hits. If one of them is a direct. Interesting. Hey, that's the same damage as the freaking Tri-Stringer. Cool. You use a Hydra? It's a bad idea. Actually, Hydra is kind of busted in this game. Freaking Booyah Bomb on a Hydra? That's kind of broken. And yet they won't give Booyah Bomb to a Charger weapon. Closest we got to that was Splashdown on the GooTuber on in Splatoon 2. Let's go. Doink. Who's keeping us waiting? Oh, Blue. Doink. Slice. Sometimes the lunge is helpful, sometimes it does a complete opposite. Just like what happened that last match. I wanted to do the normal thing, but I lunged, which completely threw me off target. I should get a conch shell after this match, but I'm gonna wait until I do the three matches this lobby. So one more time here, and then let's all do frickin' Booyah Bomb, see if that helps. I think the best weapon to have it right now is definitely the sloshing machine. I mean, it's even got fizzy bombs, so yeah. That combination on the sloshing machine is actually pretty busted. The only real downside is it's very ink hungry. You need to watch your ink consumption. You only get 11 uses on a full tank without any ink savers to speak of. 10 times about a win. We actually had one earlier. But we lost it because I decided to go try Stringer. So yeah, I blame myself for that loss. For that one. Oh. Move. Who the heck was there? Na Where did that slash go? There we go. I can't aim. It's gorgeous, just looking at the scenery. I know, the game, visually, is freaking amazing. But I still think that my favorite island is still the first one. Just because it's just really nice. And how fitting for Sega to showcase that island when it's probably the best looking one, at least in my opinion. Wait, what? That was a little confusing. I'm like, can I stop overshooting? Oops. I thought you would have gotten closer. That should have been the lunge. I was afraid I would have swooped right past him. That's funny. Doink! Okay. I just wait 10,000 years for my injury fill so I can toss a frickin' my sub-weapon at ya. I don't know what it is, but I feel like ink sufficiency in this game, regardless of what weapon you're using, is downright abysmal. Where's that suction bomb at? There it is. Wait, I didn't get you? Dang. Gonna go over here. Hopefully that was enough. Probably isn't because they were against the wall. G to the G's. Splash Up Pro in this game, I feel, is a little... isn't that good. Crab Tank is alright, but Angle Shooter... I don't know. I got a conch shell! Okay. Let's go all Booyah Bombs. Everyone select a weapon that has a Booyah Bomb. Yoink! Okay, then let's all go back Splasher. Or Sloshing Machine. Let's all do that then. Doink! Go terribly wrong. Not really. A Sloshing Machine is actually one of the better weapons in the game. Then. Booyah Bombing Society. I actually want to clip that so I can take a screenshot of that. Gonna move. Nope. Yikes. Why is this weapon so ink hungry? Nah. yeah, I'll take that double. I'm gonna toss this right here. Let's see what can come of it. And you. Hello. Have a Sprite Cranberry. Da-na-na. Wipe out! Ouch. Nit. That's what I get for literally taking my finger off the control stick to have a clip. Like Nintendo designed it that way. Yoink! Thank you for the extra turf! In other words, thank you for making it so that I can get my Booyah Bomb quicker. I was about to say, how the heck did I get that person? They were clear behind the whatchamacallit. Clank, clank. Ooh, that was close. Yoink. Oh, we had a DC. Granted, it was at the very last second, but still. How far have I gone into Frontiers? I finished up the fourth island, which is actually a really, really short. But I am kind of just now starting the fifth island. Another Green Hill like stage. Yeah, there's a lot of. They use Green Hill more often than other ones in that game, which admittedly is kind of lame. I don't know why they couldn't just make it look like the actual stages they're trying to replicate. Okay, let's see. Oh, wait. Okay, yeah, so after this match, I'm gonna do another reset. And then I'll do what Hap is doing as well. I'll let you guys decide which weapons I use. Guess there's a half hour left, so why not? Why not indeed? I'll use this weapon again though, because it's a fun weapon, but hello. What made you think that was a good idea? What made you think that was a good idea? Jeez. If you're going up here, then guess what? So was this. And so was this. Gonna create a pincer effect on you. Whoops! Geez, if the first hit's a direct hit, challenging this weapon any further almost isn't worth it. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da Your ninja squid don't help you. I can still see your trail. Yoink! Yikes! Okay. I hit somebody. I heard the hit sound effect. Wow. Hello. How'd that psychic not get you? I wanted to hit the little debris thingy. Da-na. Oh. Jeez. Hello. Can I jump? I feel bad for these guys. We're just freaking keeping them freaking pinned down. I feel bad for them. Dang. Haven't even had to get up. It's cool. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm gonna have you guys decide which weapon I use. I'm gonna do what Hap's doing. Na na da da da. Blaster, which one? Which one? Which one? Better hurry. I'm expecting company. So I'm seeing Blaster, 0.52 gal. Just plain old Blaster. Alrighty. And then I'll do 0.52 gal after the Blaster. And then Clash Blaster. And then Bamboozler. Tell you which weapon you should use? Let's see. How about Range Blaster? We'll have literally two very similar blasters. Either that or Luna. I like how they actually changed the design of the Range Blaster. It looks surprisingly Hot Wheels-esque. In fact, let me take a look at it real quick. Yeah, look at this thing. It looks very Hot Wheels-esque. The design is actually pretty cool. I like it. Which did you use? Let's see. How about you use... Okay, how about we literally just have two normal blasters and two range blasters? So two people use normal blaster, two people use range blaster. This will go either very well or very bad. Take care, Speed. Have a good one. Stay safe. Boink. Kind of struggled. The last time I used the range blaster, I did surprisingly well with it. And the fact that it's got wave breaker instantly turns its indirect hit into a one hit. That is freaking solid damage. And this one's got big bubbler. Not sure how I feel about that. Give you up an idea? Let's see. How about... There's surprisingly not that many weapons to choose from this time around. What else is there? How about roller? You're the only range blaster. We're all blasters, though. Boink. Doink. And on the range blaster, holy cow, freaking, what's the name of that ability? I can't remember what it's called. Intensify action. That ability is broken on range blaster. That is ridiculously broken. And we all thought MPU Splattershot Pro was banned Splatoon 2, and Nintendo managed to make another busted combo. Yep. Yep. Yikes! Oh, come on, I wanted to jump up there! I'm still alive, holy cow. Okay, I'm not too good at deciding where to put Big Bubbler, so I'm just gonna put it right here. Da, da, da. Ouch. Oh, I thought they had two strike strings for a second. No, that's the reflex. Da, 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 da. Yeah, there is one thing I really dislike about the range blaster. It's the mobility. It's really bad. Yikes! Autobomb, do something. The one better thing about Autobomb over Torpedo is that it can't get a shot down. Unless you use a super on it, but that's it. But there is still a part of me that kind of prefers the range blaster just because of the extra reach that it has. Ouch. Yo, imagine if the... that guy ran right into the tail end of my autobomb. Of my doggy boat. I want to clip that, actually. That was funny. I especially dislike how you can't use Big Bubbler while airborne. You have to be on the ground. Hello. Damn. Could have gotten a nice little juicy. Oh, almost got a triple. Yeah, I don't know what they did to the blasters, but in this game, Even I can perform relatively well with him. Something I couldn't normally do in Splatoon 2. Nice going, team! Like I said, we got one more match, and then I'm gonna do a lobby reset, and I think that'll be the last two games for this stream. Nine splats, okay. I'll take it. Da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, just plain vanilla roller. Vanilla. Vanilla ice cream. And then after. Oh, wait, I forgot to change my weapon. Dang it! I'm sorry. Okay, so no. After this lobby, I'm gonna use the 0.52 gal in the next one. So for one match, 0.52 gal, and then Bamboozler. Let's see what this looks like. Ooh, very spooky. That's pretty cool, though. Oh yeah, here's something. I'm not sure if I told you guys this yet, but in this game, you do technically get to choose your ink color. To run around in the square in. All you have to do is go to the replay terminal, select a replay 10 times. All right. Select a replay when you were playing a match with the ink color that you want to be. Select it. You don't have to watch the whole thing. You can just get to the point where it says, right here, ready, and then exit it, and you'll be in that ink color. So yeah, technically you do get to choose your ink color that you run around and swear in this game. Even if it takes a minute, it's so nice to have. Wow, I don't want to spark. I don't want to spark. I don't want to spark. Oh gosh, I suck. I suck. I suck. I suck. I suck. I should not have won that. Yeah, I don't know what they did with blasters in this game, but. Dang, dude. Maybe it's the indirect changes to the game itself that make them a lot easier to use. At least I think that's the case. Because there's a. The weird thing about this game is that there are so many little indirect changes made to it that really make the game a lot more quirky than the previous one. I'll take the trade. When you just left. It's okay. At least it isn't Team Fire again, so if they lose, that's two. Yep, here comes the tryhards. Face invading. Get out of here. How was that not an indirect? How was that not a direct hit? How was that not a direct hit? Well then. And welcome back. Ooh, new ideas. Let's hear it. I don't want to spark. That was two indirect hits. How are you still alive? Did they make it so that tactic cooler gives you extra health now? Direct hit! Direct hit! Wipe out! And that's a 10 times win for Team Water. GG's, let's go. I'll take a pick of that. With a mini splat lane. Noise. Wow. 880 points and I got 8 splats. What the frick? Yeah! Almost to ruler. Splatfest shells! Okay, now I'm gonna reset the lobby. This will be the last lobby I do for this stream, so 2 more games. And .52 gal? Where you be? There you are. And then Bamboozler after that. Now, I didn't get a conch shell, right? Yeah, I did. I'll actually use that after the next 2 matches. Alright, let's do it. 8 festival shells, nice. You're just taking a minute. You need one more weapon. How about... Let's see, what's a rather unorthodox weapon? Let me think. How about 0.96 gal then? I guess after this match, Bamboozler time. And if we lose, it's because I'm using that weapon. Finally got 2 shells now. Nice. Kid would be killer whale and splat bombs. Seems like a pretty good combination. Mini splatling? Yeah, that's one of my favorites actually. And if you have run speed up on that thing, it's a lot of fun. You're so freaking nimble with it, while having a little better than average range. You don't have a cow. Okay, let's see. How about Dooley Squelchers? Uh-oh. One moment. Okay, we are back. Sorry about that. Alright, let's do it. Have an idea for a challenge if Shiver wins again? Let's hear it. Seriously, it takes a while to get in a match. And the funny thing is Nintendo said that they would make it... They made it so that it takes doesn't take us long anymore. Yeah, that's fine. Hey, that's a good one, Nintendo. Okay, I am not the best with this weapon because, yeah, it's a 2-hit, which is nice, but it's not exactly the definition of accurate. Gosh darn it. So yeah, 2 hits flat. Nice. Doesn't really mean anything if the shots don't connect, you know what I mean? That, and I'm not the best at aiming, so... That just makes the accuracy even worse for me. Wait, I got somebody? Did I splat them with my splash wall? Or was that something else? Oh no, that must have been the person on top. I'm gonna clip that just in case, though. Because that was interesting. What the heck just happened? Oh my gosh, I suck. Oh, how are you still alive? No, you are not alive, good sir. Nuh-uh. This is not a 3-hit spat weapon. You are not alive, good sir. Give chase. Oh, I wish I could aim. And then again, that was probably on me because I jumped, making the weapon even more inaccurate than it already is. Oh my gosh. Okay, gotta move. Oh, I wish I could aim, but I can't. I wish I could aim, but I can't. Tuna can. Tuna fish. We lost that one. Bleh. Okay, one second. Whew, okay. I apologize. Bounce Guy Sanctuary. That's another one. Halftime report. Let's see what we got. We're the defending team. Cool. I wanna know what it's like to be defending. Yep. There we go. And show him who's boss. Time for tricolor battles. Defending sucks. Let's find out. However, I still have one more match to go for this stream, so yeah. Oh, the new Summer Run map is open. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna enter the lobby once more. And we have one more, I have one more match to go for the stream. Next stream, I'll be doing Tricolor. Okay, bamboo. Just beat people up with a stick. And real quickly, let me check out the... not the best weapon comp, but... eh. Sure beats spawning ground, that's for sure. Sheesh. Okay, let's go. I know, the only time you can actually enter Tricolor is if you go to the option. 1 a.m.? Dang. Yeah, please do get some rest. Please do get some sleep. Have a good one, stay safe. And take care. Thank you for joining. Another Killer Whale 5.1 weapon. To tap. To tap. Okay. Alright, let's do it. This will be the last match of the stream, and then I'm gonna have to call it, well, a stream. But I will be back tomorrow for the wrapping up of this Splatfest. We'll be trying out some Tricolor Turf Wars. Can't get the... what? Oh, defending team gets thrown in Tricolor at... oh. Okay, that actually kind of sucks. Why don't they give you the option? That's actually kind of stupid. Tell you what weapon to use? I guess Charger then. I hope this isn't a Tricolor though, because I'm not really prepared for that going in with this weapon. But I still gotta use it. Which charger? Maybe just the vanilla one. Plain old vanilla charger. Vanilla ice cream. Cozy, how's it going? Welcome. We're starting to believe Freya's never going to win a Splatfest. I'm pretty sure she'll win one at least. Let's go. Okay, hopefully it isn't Tricolor. I'm not prepared to do that with this weapon. Unless I just run in there and beat them up with the stick itself. Battle time. And it's once again on Insurgent Shipyard. So if we see that map... okay, good. No Tricolor. Just a normal one. What was our first Splatoon game? My first one was Splatoon 2. I almost bought Splatoon 1, which I regret not doing. But I might buy it just to play the story mode, because I imagine playing online matches now is it's not exactly ideal. Wow. I can't believe I pulled that off. I'm gonna clip that real quick. I can't believe I managed to do that. It pays to have a higher sensitivity sometimes. Oh, I don't have the range. I was behind the wall, excuse me. I am thinking someone is lagging. Someone must be lagging. Wipe out. Nope. I kind of don't want to get up there, but I kind of do. Yeah, I know that was a stupid idea. First try, nice! There's still a bunch of people, surprisingly. Maybe this game makes them want to play it again. Get down from there. Oh my gosh. I suddenly remembered why I use Ink Res. But I feel like Ink Res has been nerfed in this game. Could just be me. I got somebody at least. It's funny because I feel like I'm less sticky in enemy ink without it than I am with it. That was stupid. Hap really wanted me to suffer, but this weapon didn't. And want us to lose! How are you still alive? Yeah, that's what I thought, you're not. How are we still in the danger zone? Got a triple at the end. Like, how are we still in the danger zone after that? Yet you chose the worst possible charger. Okay, I take that back. I think YouTuber's worse than this. Honestly. So it's not the worst possible one, but it's still one of the ones that kind of suck. Okay, so let's see. Let's see what I get from the shell out machine. Probably something completely useless. Yep. Thanks for nothing. Okay. But, with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a stream right here. So, let's see everyone who is currently in the lobby with me. We've got, see, Marcy. Who else we got? We have Blue, myself, and Hap. So, with that being said, I'm going to see you guys tomorrow for the... Oh, what the frick? Oh, check that out. Lolz. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and call it a stream right here. So, thank you guys for joining me. Hope you all had fun. I'll see you tomorrow for the wrapping up of this Splatfest. Hopefully we'll get into some tricolor turf wars. I really think Nintendo should make it give you the option to do it instead of throwing you in randomly, which is kind of stupid. It kind of defeats the purpose, I mean, seriously. But yes, with that being said, I'm gonna call it a stream right here. I'll see you guys tomorrow for the wrapping up of this Splatfest. So, thank you guys for joining me. Hope you all had fun. Until next time, love you all. Take care.